Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. The women came to the tomb early this morning. They came to mourn the one they lost. They came on a mission to the grave. Maybe this morning, even with the joy of Easter, even with the lilies and the Easter baskets and the new outfits and the chocolate eggs and the peeps, and with the feasts at home on the table, maybe we can relate a little to these women. They were exhausted and broken. They came assuming, knowing death has the last word. They came mourning the one they'd lost. They came feeling so guilty over everything that had happened. And how many of us have come to this Easter in the same way? Tired, broken down, overwhelmed by the death that seems to rule the world, burdened with our own guilt, remembering what we ourselves have loved and lost. So like the women, we too grieve this morning. In this life, no matter who we are, we are all on a mission to the grave. But suddenly, there was a great earthquake. And out of nowhere, the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and rolled back the tombstone and sat on it. That great cold stone, that great black period at the end of Jesus' life, that immovable rock of death, was rolled back like nothing, thrown aside like a paper cup, cracked open beyond repair, and instead of cowering down before it, the angel just sat on it. What we take to be the end of it all, the angel just sits on happily, like he's lounging on a lazy boy. Because of his appearance, his brightness, white hot like lightning, the guards stationed at the tomb shook with fear and became like dead men. Look at these guards. Pilots, soldiers, the same ones who didn't bat an eye as they nailed Jesus' feet and hands into that wooden cross. These guards, so pitiless, shake now with fear. They are powerless, helpless. For now, everything in this world that tries to play God and have the last word over our lives, every dark and merciless power in our life, everything that tries to destroy our human worth and dignity is now beaten and vanquished and helpless. For Christ is risen from the dead, trampling over death by his death. But like all angels, this one has a message. The first message of Easter for the women, the first message of Easter for you and for me, and it's very simple. Don't be afraid. How about that? Huh? Angels, earthquakes, toss boulders, guards, shaking, but don't be afraid. Or better, you need not be afraid. You don't have to be afraid anymore. Whatever is in your life this morning, whatever you've lost, whatever you dread, whatever your guilt, you need not be afraid. I know you are looking for Jesus who was crucified, says the angel. I know you think you're on a mission to the grave. I know you're grieving, But Jesus, who died for you, who was crucified on the cross for you, who took away the sins of the world for you, who died your death for you, who is buried in your tomb for you, he is not here. He has been raised, just as he said. And now he goes ahead of you. He is not ended. He is not lost. He's not sunk down to death forever, but has been raised up anew, conquering in glory, bursting forth from the tomb in new and unending life. Death could not hold him. And now death cannot hold you, for he has led the way into life everlasting. So go quickly, the angel says. Go and tell his disciples he has been raised, and he is going ahead of you. There he will meet you. And as the women went, with no proof, nothing to hold on to, but just a word, just a promise, there on the way, Jesus met them. He came to them and said, "Greetings. Hey, hi." Or maybe a better translation, "Rejoice. Here he is. Come to you. Rejoice. He has been raised. Rejoice. Death has been trampled down by death. Rejoice. Life has won. Rejoice. He lives and you will live also. Rejoice. God has emptied the power of death and hell forever. Rejoice." The bitter suffering of Good Friday is now a great victory. Rejoice. Every sorrow, every loss, every heartache you carry this morning and that our world mourns is met and transformed with one word from the mouth of our flesh and blood living Savior. Rejoice. And the women knelt down and they took hold of his flesh and blood wounded feet. And they held him onto those feet, still marked by the scars. Now transformed into glorious wounds, they held on and worshipped him. They held him for just a moment, but that was enough. In a minute, here in the Holy Communion, you also will have a moment to kneel down and to hold him in your hands and on your tongue and worship him, not just his feet, but his whole living self in your hands. The gift of his risen body and blood and bread and wine given and shed in love for you and me. For the earth has shifted this morning. The ground under our feet has shaken and changed. For the stone is rolled away. Death could not hold him and will not hold you. Our mission is no longer toward the grave, but we are on a mission towards life, eternal life with him forever. So don't be afraid. Go and tell with your life that he is risen, for he goes ahead of you now, and in your life, there he will meet you. For alleluia, Christ is risen, he is risen indeed, alleluia.